Hi guys, welcome to Street Bite. And if you are looking for some Pondi flavors in Hyderabad, Pondi Parotas is the best place to walk in at Hitex in Hitex City. So they have very good varieties of food, and the Kottu Parota is the best pick here. Mr. Raj, who is the owner of Pondi Parotas, will explain about the best dishes you need to try here. What is the concept behind Pondi Parotas and how it all started? So, Mr. Raj, please.
Hi, this is Raj. I'm the owner of Pondi Parotas. And the concept of Pondi Parotas we started is mainly because of bringing the Pondicherry cuisine to Hyderabad. Very special soup from Pondicherry. It's called Pondicherry Mutton Bone Soup. The rich bones flavor you'll be getting in this. It's a very healthy soup also. It's spicy because it has to be spicy, because when you are having throat infection or fever, this is the best soup which you can have. If you complete the soup, after that you'll feel very energetic.
So at last, so there's a place which serves Ambur chicken biryani.
Right.
So basically we did a video on best 10 biryanis in Hyderabad, which is not Hyderabadi.
Right.
So we want to showcase the best different 10 different types of biryanis, which is not Hyderabadi.
Right.
But fortunately, at last we found something which is Ambur style biryani.
Right.
So can you explain, this is Zira Sambar rice, right?
Yeah, we make with Siraga Sambar rice. The rice name itself is Siraga Sambar. And in Hyderabad and Andhra area, they call it as Chitti Muthiyalu rice. The same rice in West Bengal, it is very famous rice called Gobind Bhog. So, because they offer this light rice to Lord Krishna. That's how the name came as Gobind Bhog. It's a food for Lord Krishna. And it's a very, very aromatic rice. When you make the biryani, when you taste it, the meat will go very well with the biryani, mix very well with the biryani, and the flavor itself is, half of the flavor comes from the rice itself. That's the speciality of this rice, Ambur chicken biryani.
And there is a place in Hyderabad which serves some authentic Ambur biryani.
Correct. So we make in a very, very authentic way of making this biryani. It's again a dum biryani. The masalas, meat and rice cook together to make this biryani.
So do you take any party orders for Ambur biryani?
Like yeah, we take. We already served for around 100 people party orders. Already it's getting clicked up, it's getting popular in Hyderabad. We are getting orders for this. This is named as Kalaki. Across Tamil Nadu you'll get this dish. So the major content of this dish is egg itself. The outer layer is fully filled with egg and inside it is filled with prawn. So it's called prawn kalaki, it is called. So
it's nothing but a prawn omelette.
Yeah, it's a different style of making egg. It will not taste like an omelette. It will actually, the way of making is inside it will be little semi-boiled. Outside it will be boiled. But some customers prefer as boiled, some customers don't prefer boiled.
Like off-boiled.
So we make it here little boiled only. So you get a mix of chicken kalaki, egg kalaki or prawn kalaki. This is the differentiation in that. So combinations we have in this.
So this is your traditional Kottu Parota. People are seriously looking for some Kottu Parota places in Hyderabad, because
right.
I hardly found any places who serve Kottu Parota.
Right.
So tell me something about Kottu Parota, because you know, there are a lot of inquiry about Kottu Parota in Hyderabad. I know your place in Madhuranagar,
right.
But tell me something about the crowded Hitex City.
Yeah. So this is one of the very fast moving items in Hitex City. Kottu itself is a word from Tamil. It is called, Kottu means chop it. So chop it well, that is called Kottu. That's the name originated Kottu Parota.
Okay.
So we mince the parota. Parota is minced on the tawa. That's how we make it. The speciality of making Kottu Parota and Pondi Parotas is we flap the parota and stuff onions and masalas inside and then close it. It will become a ball dough type.
Yes.
We cook it on the tawa. The whole ball content will get cooked on the tawa. So what happens in this process, it will become a cooker type inside. So all the pressure will be inside and the flavor will be cooked properly inside. And then the chef mash it into pieces and then add keema, then add egg. So what happens in this process, the whole flavor will be absorbed in the parota itself. So this will go very good with the gravy what we are giving. It's a chicken stew. And this is a very special raita we provide for this. This raita is a mix of curd with onion, thick raita it is. The difference between this raita is to Hyderabad normal other raitas which you see in Hyderabad is this will not have water.
It's very consistent.
Yeah. So it will go very good with the combination of Kottu Parota and the gravy. That's the seafood what we are having. That's crab, chettinad special gravy it is. It is a typical homemade masala. We use the homemade masalas for this because otherwise we will not get the, if we buy the masalas from shop, other shops, we will not get that flavor. if you smell that, you get a rich crab flavor in that. With pepper flavor.
A lot of people are asking how to eat a crab because I am from in a coastal area.
Yeah.
So we are very much used to having crabs.
Right.
So
The, simple way of eating a crab is just take the whole crab, chew it and then spit the remaining content. So that's the best way, so that you can get the whole content of the crab. If you use the tools, you will not get the
just chew it and extract the pulp and you just chew it out.
Right. Since the coastal area people are very familiar to eat crabs, it is go well with them. It is now clicking out very well with the Hitex unit. This is not available in our other unit, Amirpet, for other reasons, but Hitex, it's clicking very well. So it will go very good with the rice. We are providing crab gravy with dosa also. This is a very different combination, you'll be hearing this, because in my native, you'll get the crab gravy with dosa. So it will go very good combination.
So you're making a base with tomato gravy or completely chettinad style? Because Andhra style, they add tamarind pulp, tamarind puree to make a crab gravy.
This is a typical chettinad style of making crab gravy. You'll get a rich pepper flavor and the crab flavor. These are the only two flavors you'll be getting in that.
Anyway, nothing can dominate the flavor of a crab. I can seriously smell it.
Right. Right, it will be rich content of crab. Crab smell will be coming in that.
So actually, crabs are very much familiar or famous only in New Moon Day and Full Moon Day.
Yeah, actually there is a saying, right?
Yes,
and they say the other thing also. When it is during the full moon day, if you get a crab, you will get a good flesh content in that. If
you are with the egg.
Flesh with the egg, right? If you are going for other days, for example, if not a full moon day, the crab will lay the egg, and the body content of the crab will also go along with that.
And even on the no moon day, you will have a lot of crab egg.
Right.
So every 15 days, on the no moon day and even on the full moon day, if you get some crabs, fresh crabs from some rivers, you will find very good salty lakes.
Right.
You get very good
crab eggs in there. Yeah. So crab egg itself is tasting very good. It will taste a real good.
You need to cook the crab separately, and then you need to just add the crab eggs into the curry.
Yeah.
So it will be something like, you know,
like a masala flavor. I mean, it will be a ball type of kind of thing. And it
will be something like a butter.
Right.
You can just chew it out.
Right.
And people who get used to crab will get addicted.
Yeah, We should not miss the egg in that.
Yes.
Egg is one of the very flavored item in that. This is a Ceylon paratha. Ceylon is nothing but an old name of Sri Lanka. So it is a very, very famous street food of Sri Lanka. And we wanted Hyderabad customers to taste this food. The name itself is Ceylon paratha for this, because of the origin where it is coming from. There is a stuffing inside. It will come with egg, chicken, paneer or mutton.
Whatever, maybe the
These are the combinations we give to the customer, and customers can select whatever combinations they want. The speciality of this is the masala is made separately and then stuffed into the paratha. It is not cooked together. Masala is freshly prepared, then the masala is stuffed inside. And in this you get mutton flavor will be very good, chicken flavor will be very good. And paneer version for vegetarians. I get more vegetarian orders for paneer, mostly. Right.
So you have any vegetable kind of food? In vegetable, in veg, do you have only paneer or vegetarian stuff?
So we have a very veg Ceylon paratha also. Veg Ceylon will have the content of capsicum, cabbage, little aloo in that, which is the filling we'll have, and that will be veg Ceylon. Paneer will have a different filling for that. Every different items will taste different. So this is the origin of Arabian paratha it is. So this will not be spicy, but it will be very good paratha if you have it with the stew what we are giving. It will come with the veg stew and chicken stew. So at Pondi Paratha's Hitex, we have taken care a lot about the interiors. The one main reason for concentrating on the interiors here is we would want the customers to get the feel of Pondicherry. So one of the interiors I would want to say here is the whole street what you are seeing here is one of the famous street of Pondicherry. This is a beach road of Pondicherry, and these are the two buildings. You would have seen this in most of the movies, this scenery. And we have a rickshaw also. This rickshaw is, if you even go to Pondicherry today, you can still get a ride in rickshaw. So you can even ride your own rickshaw. So that's the typical culture of Pondicherry. It still replicates, and we wanted to have a rickshaw inside our shop. And this is the architecture of Pondicherry. This is how there will be a good balcony, and the windows will be elevated outside. And this is how exactly the Pondicherry streets look like. Even if you see the ceiling here, we fill the ceiling with bamboo buckets here, and the lightings are given accordingly. Most of the Pondicherry rural culture you'll be seeing here at Pondi Parotas at Hitex. And there we have a Pondicherry map, which is very unique way of doing presenting it. We have done it with motherboard. The whole thing what you're seeing is a white town of Pondicherry. It's a real size map of Pondicherry. We had a designer, we had a very good designer who is from NIFT, Mr. Trinesh, has done this thing for us. And the bottom area of that is the sea. And the beauty of the map itself is every street is parallel to the roads which connects to the beach. That's the beauty of architecture of Pondicherry.